Derikas Lou praėjusiame sezone sėkmingai žaidęs Pasvalio pieno žvaigždėse sulaukė skambučio iš Stepono Babrausko ir šis paskatino sugrįžti į vos 7000 gyventojų turintį miestelį. Amerikietis Lietuvoje jaučiasi apsipratęs.
It's a lot different than Hawaii for sure, but I think this is like, I don't know, what is it, going on my 7th or 8th season, so you kind of get used to how things are, you get used to doing things, adjusting and adapting to life, different than how it is at home. So although it is a lot different, kind of figured out how to do things, so it's okay. Pretty much everything else, pretty adjusted. Weather, I don't think my body will ever be able to adjust to the weather. My body just doesn't, it doesn't work in the cold, so that's the only thing.
Lou prieš atvykdamas į Pasvalį sezoną praleido be krepšinio. Iš žaidėjas tai aiškino namų ilgesiu, kadangi Europoje jis visada laiką leidžia vienas ir ilgainiui tai ima slėgti.
I just didn't want to play, because it's for us, for Americans, to spend 10 months overseas, it's a long time, and the seasons are long. It's hard on your body, it's hard, mentally, because, majority of those 10 months you spend alone, you have a routine, you go to practice, you come home, you have the whole day off, then you go to practice maybe in the evening, and then it's the same thing every single day for 10 long months. And after a while, I kind of just I missed a lot of things at home. I at the blink of an eye, my little brother, I remember when he was born, and then now he graduated high school, and it was just like, what happened? Like, seriously. And just people get older as time goes by. I mean, time goes by quick, you can't stop time. So, but what I'm trying to say, like, a lot happens in 10 months that I missed a lot of things back at home with family and friends and stuff. So, one of the reasons was to, just take a break and kind of enjoy home, enjoy family, and kind of make up for all that lost time.
Daugybė amerikiečių yra labai religingi. Pieno žvaigždžių legionierius neišimtis. Jis bažnyčioje nesilanko, bet pamaldas stebi internetu ir tai jam padeda pasijausti tarsi namuose.
I am proud to be a Christian, and I take that to heart, and try to do my best to follow my faith and my beliefs. A lot of people kind of take it differently, but when I think of being Christian, I just think of being a good person, treating other people well, and just try to do things to lead by example, So I really try to stick to that, and no matter what, at the end of the day, just try to do my best to mirror, my faith in God. So yeah, Christianity, that's who I am. It's kind of hard, yeah. I mean, I don't think they will speak English too much in church, but I know there's one church over here. I see it, but I haven't gone to it, So that's it. But I do, like, thank you for internet these days, because I'm all the way here in Lithuania, but I can watch church services back in home, So it's like I'm still at home.
Lou kol kas aukščiausias karjeros taškas – žaidimas Europos taurėje. Iš žaidėjas turėjo galimybę debituoti pajėgiausiame Europos klubų turnyre 2009 metų rudenį su Vilniaus Lietuvos ryto apranga. Bet tuomet pabūgo griežtos rankos šalininko Rimo Kurtinaičio. Dabar pašnekovas šiek tiek gailisi dėl tuomet praleistos galimybės rungtyniauti Eurolygoje.
I think it's always a dream, but I think you have to be realistic sometimes, and could I play? For sure, like, no doubt. I think I have, definitely the skills to play, but sometimes it's not in my control, Sometimes you need a good resume and profile to go on a EuroLeague team, and I just don't have a good resume and profile. And that's just how it is. After my season in Cholet, like 6 or 7 years ago, I think Ritas had offered me, and at that time they were in EuroLeague, but I said no, because Honestly, like, I really, really think that Kurt Nitis is a really good coach, but I think he was a little too scary for me. So I was like, oh, I don't know if I would have played well, because he's a very intense coach. I can't remember all the teams, but I mean, Cholet was EuroCup, not EuroLeague, but you know, EuroCup, and that was fun. And you know, I played Euro Challenge and played VTB League with Azamash. But you know, other than that, I didn't really get a good opportunity to play on a EuroLeague team. But maybe one day, maybe not. But we'll see. Now, come to think about it, well, you know, because back then I was young, you know, and you don't know the kind of things that I know now as a older, a little bit more experienced player. So when I was younger, all I was thinking was like, Kurtinaitis, you know, EuroLeague, Kurtinaitis, like, Kurtinaitis, he's too crazy for me. That's all I was thinking. And yes, now come to think about it, I told Stepas, I made a mistake. Like, I should have taken that thing, you know, I should have said yes. But I was like, oh, what can I do? You know, because now a little bit older, now I kind of can see, I was like, you know, I appreciate coaches like that a little bit more. Like, you know, can learn a lot more from coaches like Kurtinaitis and stuff. So, you know, a little bit regret, but you know, what can I do now, you know? So just move on and try to continue to do my best.